Hey, what's up, guys? The rain just ended in Great Smoky Mountains National Park. The sun's out. A lot of people are coming out to shoot now. Now that the sun is coming out, it's warming up and it's not damp anymore. But I'm actually going back in. Why? Because I love shooting out in the rain. I love rain as a condition for landscape photography. And there are so many things that you can actually shoot in the rain. For example, when you're shooting in the rain and when you're shooting like outdoors in damp, rainy conditions, a lot of times you're not gonna have a lot of crowds. People aren't gonna be around, people aren't gonna be getting in your shot. So that's one of the reasons why I love shooting in rainy conditions, because I basically have places all to myself. I can work around different compositions. I can figure out the best places to shoot, especially if I'm shooting in really popular locations. Like a lot of these locations and waterfalls in the Smokies are really popular and you have a lot of crowds. In the rain, basically no one there except photographers. So that's one of the reasons why I love wet, rainy conditions for my photography. Another reason is that when it rains, a lot of times it brings out more vibrance and greens, and that's especially beneficial in waterfall photography because a lot of the mosses and algae that are growing along the rocks on the edges of waterfalls or on the edges of streams, those brighten up and get more vibrant green as that rain falls and they get more moist and more damp. It really brings out a lot of that green color, helping you to create more impactful photos of waterfalls. So that's another reason why I love rainy conditions for landscape photography. Lastly, rainy conditions increase the amount of water that is in waterfall locations. Increasing the flow of water, increasing the speed and how rapid the water is flowing over rocks really helps me as a landscape photographer for waterfall photography, just because when that happens and when that speed happens, to me and for my style, it creates more dynamic, impactful waterfall images and helps me create compositions where water is just like flowing straight into the camera lens. So I love those conditions. But if you're in rain, like cameras are really fragile, they're really expensive. How do you protect your camera equipment when you're in the rain? Well, my number one thing for doing when I'm photographing in the rain and protecting my camera gear is I use a Peak Design shell. And basically what this is it's basically a hood that fits over your camera like this. Has a drawstring that allows you to cinch up the end of your lens and get it really nice and tight on there. It's made with waterproof fabric so that the rain just like rappels right off of it. And then the back hood also has a drawstring that you can pull and tighten up for when you're hiking, when you have that strapped over your shoulder or something. And then before you shoot, you can actually loosen this up a good bit and pull it up over so you can see the back LCD screen on your camera. This is a really good product. I'll link it below in the video description for you as well. I love my shell. I use it all the time when I'm going out to shoot. Also has like a cool little built-in rain hood for your lens right here that you can use to kind of repel water. Sometimes water does get down into your lens. That's when a lens hood is handy. Or if you have like a microfiber cloth, that's really useful whenever you're going out to shoot in the rain too, because you can just wipe off any moisture that gets on the end of your lens. I'll link one of those below in the video description as well for you to check out. Those are super cheap. You should probably pack like 3 to 4 in your bag anytime you're going out to shoot, because when one gets wet, you can take out the next one, dry it off. When that one gets wet, take out the next one, and so on. So those are two things you can have with you. A third thing you can definitely have with you is something that I don't use, but I've heard a lot of other photographers use them, and that's one of those rocket air blasters, a little air blaster that you can squeeze and it blows air out of the end of it, and you can just get water off of the end of your lens with one of those air blasters just by blowing air using the pressure of your finger on the squeeze part of the air blaster. Those are really good for like waterfalls. If you get a lot of mist coming off of a waterfall, you can use one of those air blasters on it. Or if you get mist damp rain coming in onto the end of your lens, you can use one of those too. Guys, I would highly encourage you to get out in the rain to shoot more dramatic landscapes, shoot more dramatic situations, and allow you to capture a lot more interesting features that people normally don't see. When you get out in the rain, you have more dramatic landscapes rather than what people always see when they come out with like sunny conditions or cloudy conditions. That stuff's shot all the time. Get out in abnormal weather situations and shoot to create better landscape photography. If you like this video, you found it useful at all, hit that thumbs up button. If you're into landscape photography, consider subscribing to this channel. And always comment below if you're using something that I didn't mention that you and other people can use to impact and improve their photography in the rain. Go ahead and comment with those things below in the video description. Always continuing watching is always an option too. So if you want to do that, you can click on the playlist that's showing on your screen right now.